Good morning, friends. In the last lectures, we studied design of the welded joints. In the design of the welded joints, when the load is because of the loads, the bending stress is induced. Means for welded joints subjected to bending moments, we studied. For horizontal welds, for vertical welds, and combinations of the horizontal and vertical weld. Today we'll see one two problems when the weld is circular, load is again bending moment, and this is hole, this is circular. And this distance equal to this is 55, this is problems actually. First, I draw figures for understanding purpose. Note down, today's problems for circular welds. A circular shaft in diameter, is welded to a support by means of a fillet weld as shown in figure. And in figure, determine shear stress in the weld. Determine the size of the weld, shear stress in the weld is limited to (100 N/mm²). 100 newton per mm square. So in these problems we require more space to solve the problems. That's why I divided this problem into 3 modes. So in this case, and this diameter is and this is T is the thickness of the weld, or first otherwise suppose this is the element area dA and this T is the thickness of the weld and this is Y, this angle is the theta and this is d theta and this is r. So that's why, because this is r and this area is the dA and this is d theta. So that's why this is element area. Now this arc equal to d theta equal to arc length divided by arc radius. So that's why arc length equal to r into d theta and this elemental area dA equal to, because t is the thickness, so that's why we can write r into d theta into t, right? And here's primary shear stress induced, that is equal to tau 1 equal to primary shear stress p divided by area equal to 2 pi and this is 10,000 divided by, now circumference, and this is 2 pi r into T. This 10,000, 2 pi r equal to, this is 50 means 25 That's why this is 10,000 divided by 2 divided by pi divided by 25 and this is equal to 63.66 divided by T. This is primary shear stress. Next, or this is shear stress, no need of the call primary chicken because the another stress is the sigma b. Sigma b equal to m by z, m divided by I divided by y, and this is nothing but m divided by I, and this m equal to 10,000 multiplied by 200, and this is 1 into 10 to the power 6 Newton mm. And y is the distance, so in this case y equal to, so actually this is r, 25 mm, right? In this case. Now we requires moment of inertia. So moment of inertia equal to Ixx, about Xx axis, or general moment of inertia equal to, so we can take this is formula, A into Y squares, because this is symmetrical, that's why, and this is circular. Area equal to, now this is elemental area, so that's why we can consider this is dA into, now whole area equal to I dA into y squares. Right. So this y equal to theta or sine theta equal to sine theta front side y divided by r, or y equal to r sine theta. R sine theta. Now put value of, by putting value of delta A and Y in equation first. So that's why this equation becomes delta A equal to R into d theta multiplied by t, and this y equal to r sines theta squares. Now this is integration, and here this is 360 degree, So that's why we can take this is 2, 0 to pi, and this is 0 to pi for half and for remaining, that's why here is multiplied by 2. Now r squares and this t, so that's why t r cube into sine square theta multiplied by d theta. I equal to now 2 by taking commons, yes, t into r cube in brackets 0 to limits, messes 0 to, and this is sine square theta into d theta. Now sine square theta equal to, because cos 2 theta equal to 1 plus sin square theta. So that's why sin square theta equal to, we can write this is cos 2 theta, or this is by taking I think this is formula 1 minus sin square theta cos 2 theta equal to. So that's why sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta. Right. Now putting I equal to 2 t r cube, and this is 1 minus cos 2 theta into d theta. This is clear. Now by taking integrations, I equal to 2 t r cube, this is 1 into theta minus this is actually plus, becomes 2 theta divided by 2, and this is 0 to pi. So actually this is 1 minus 2 sin square theta. So sin square theta equal to divided by 2. This is correct. That's why this becomes pi by 2, and this is So this terms becomes, because pi equal to 0, and finally we will get 2 into, this is pi divided by 2, this 2 will get cancelled, and this is pi t r cube, moment of inertia equal to. Now put this value of the moment of inertia, sigma b equal to m equal to, we already calculate this 1 into 10 to the power 6 y equal to 25, and this is pi t r cube means 25 cube. Now this 25 and this is will get cancelled, sigma b equal to 10 to the power 6 divided by pi divided by 25 square. This is equal to
Is there any mistake?
Ten to the power six.
Oh,
here's two. That's why this is two into 10 to the power 6 divided by 1018.59 divided by t. Now, by using according to the maximum shear stress theory, tau equal to half into sigma b square plus 4 tau squares. Now, I take commons 1 by t, sigma b equal to 1018.59 square plus 4 into tau equal to 63.66 bracket square plus 63.66 square into 4, and this is under root. Square multiplied by 4 plus 01859 square. This is equal to under root 37355. Divided by 2t equal to divided by 2. This is 513.25 divided by t. Now, tau equal to, this is given 100. So that's why 100. 513.25 divided by t, and this t equal to 5.1325 mm, and size of the weld equal to, you can consider this is 5.1325 divided by 707. This is equal to 7.25 mm. This is size of the weld. This is clear. Now again, I will take one more problems similar to these problems. That's why you can understand better. A solid circular shaft, note down. Next problem is, a solid circular shaft
a solid circular shaft 30 mm in diameter is welded to a support by means of a fillet weld as shown in figure. Determine the dimension. Dimensions means T and H. Dimensions of the weld if the yield point strength, in this case yield point strength, is 380 mega Pascal. Factor of safety is 2. So that's why I write here sigma or tau equal to 0.5 sigma yt divided by factor of safety. This is basic formula, factor of safety 0.5 sigma yt. This is 380 and divided by 2. This is 190 divided by 2. This is 95 mega Pascal. Clear? Now, area equal to formula 2 pi r into T. So that's why 2 pi is 30 mm. So this is 30 mm and this force is given 5 kilonewton and this distance is the 100 mm. Now this is 30, that's why this is 15 into T. Area equal to 2 into pi multiplied by 15. This 94.2477 into T. That's why tau equal to, I can write, this is P divided by A. P equal to 5 kilonewtons, 5000 divided by 53.05 divided by T. Tau equal to first equation. Now, I repeat design procedures because you can understand. Here's Y equal to, this distance is the Y. Y equal to means by using formula sine theta equal to फ्रंट साइड y डिवाइडेड बाय r और y इक्वल टू r इंटू साइन थीटा एंड दिस d थीटा इक्वल टू आर्क लेंथ डिवाइडेड बाय एंड दिस इज रेडियस. बेसिक फार्मूला डी थीटा इक्वल टू आर्क लेंथ इक्वल टू डिवाइडेड बाय रेडियस. दैट्स वाई आर्क लेंथ इक्वल टू आर इंटू डी थीटा. नाउ द स्मॉल एलिमेंटल एरिया स्मॉल एलिमेंट्री एरिया डेल्टा ए इक्वल टू और डेल्टा ए इक्वल टू यू कैन राइट दिस इज आर्क लेंथ मल्टीप्लाइड बाय टी इज द थिकनेस आर इंटू डी थीटा मल्टीप्लाइड बाय टी एंड वाई इक्वल टू दिस. सो दैट्स वाई मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया इक्वल टू इंटीग्रेशंस और दिस इज ए जनरल फार्मूला ए वाई बार स्क्वेयर्स एंड दिस इज बिकॉज सर्कुलर दैट्स वाई वी कैन कंसिडर टू एंड दिस इज जीरो टू पाई एरिया इक्वल टू आर इंटू डी थीटा इंटू टी वाई इक्वल टू आर साइन थीटा एंड दिस इज स्क्वेयर. दैट्स वाई दिस इज आर क्यूब इंटू टी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय साइन स्क्वेयर थीटा इंटू डी थीटा और बाय टेकिंग कॉमन्स आई इक्वल टू टू इंटू टी आर क्यूब साइन स्क्वेयर theta into this is sin square theta. Now formula cos 2 theta equal to and this is formula one minus sin square theta. This is 2 sin square theta. That's why 2 sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta and sin square theta equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. Now put this cos sin square theta in these equations. This is 2 t r cube 0 to pi. Here's in bracket 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2 into d theta 2 t r cube. Now by take integrations half, so that's why half into theta and this is plus because minus minus becomes change sin 2 theta divided by this is 2 and this 2 and this is 0 to pi. So this terms right hand side because sin theta equal to sin 0 equal to 0 and sin pi equal to 0. So that's why I equal to 2 t r cube pi divided by 2, this will get cancelled. And this is general formula pi t r cube. Now sigma b equal to, what is formula? M into y divided by I. M equal to 5000 multiplied by distance 100. Y is the distance of the extreme fiber from neutral axis. This is 30. So that's why
This is 30 divided by 2. Yi equal to, by using formula, pi t r cube. Now that's why this is 30 divided by 2 and this is divided by, or directly can I write, yes, this is 15 and this is 15 cube. Now this is 115 will get cancelled and you will get finally 5000 multiplied by 100 divided by 15 squares divided by 5000 multiplied by 100 divided by 15 square divided by pi, and this is equal to sigma b equal to 707 divided by t, this t. Now by using maximum Alousian stress theory, I have taken this is 1 by 2t, means t commons, and this is sigma b square plus 4 tau squares, tau equal to sigma b equal to 707 square plus 4 and theta equal to 53.05 squares. That's why tau equal to 4 into 53.05 square. This is under root 715.26 divided by 2t, and this is 95 divided by 2, 357.63 divided by t, or t equal to, this is throat, divided by 95, 3.764 mm, and h equal to, divided by, directly I am writing 5.3, purposefully directly I am writing, this is 324 mm. So this is your dimensions of the whale. This is clear. Now, so last articles related with the welded joints is the when the welded joint subjected to torsional movement. So this is last type of the, when the torque is acting on a circular shaft. So that times how you can calculate. This is last type of the problems. This is a simple, because I derive and after that solve the problems. Welded joint
subjected to.
Torsional moment. This is very easy. Suppose this is a and this is a weldings and here torque is acting. This is torque is or this torque is acting. This is circular shaft. So in this case, no load actings, instead of the loads actings, here's torque is actings. So that's why, and this is R is the radius. So I will draw, this is big, size above the this is XX axis. And this is YY axis. And suppose this element area equal to this is DA, this is R, and this is Y, and this is theta, this is D theta. First, I will derive this because for such type of the loadings, so we have to use equation because only torque actings. So that's why. T divided by J equal to tau divided by R. This is the torque equations. You can calculate the torque. And now J is the polar moment of any shaft. This is allowable shear stress and R is the radius above the shaft. So that's why here's torque equal to load divided by if load actings. Otherwise if the torque directly given, no need multiplied by radius, you can calculate. J equal to, this is polar moment of inertia. Polar moment of inertia equal to formula Ixx plus Iyy. Now, how you can calculate the Ixx? Ixx equal to, again here's, this is Ay squares. Now, A equal to area. Area equal to, suppose dA equal to directly, can I write here? This is R into d theta into T and Y equal to sine theta equal to Y divided by R. So that's why Y equal to R sine theta. Clear? So that's why A equal to or Ixx equal to, now by putting value of the dA and Y in these equations, and this is 0 to pi and this is we are calculating about Xx axis. So that's why whole means multiplied by 2 into this A equal to R into d theta into T and this is R sine theta squares. That's why Ixx equal to, now this is 2 0 to pi TR cube, because this is R cube multiplied by sine square theta into d theta. Now again by using formula cos 2 theta equal to 1 minus 2 sine square theta. So that's why 2 sine square theta by taking in the left hand side, 1 minus cos 2 theta, or sine square theta equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. This is basic. That's why Ixx equal to 0 to pi. Now putting sin squares, here I can take 2 into t r cube commons, and this is 1 minus cos 2 theta divided by 2 and multiplied by d theta. Clear? Ixx equal to 2 t r cube. Now by taking integrations, half into theta minus sine, and this is actually minus sine 2 theta, and this is half divided by 2, and this is 0 to pi. Second terms becomes 0 2 t r cube multiplied by this is pi. This 2 will get cancelled, and this is Ixx equal to pi into t r cube. Similarly, moment of inertia about xx axis and moment of inertia about yy axis, that is also same because this is symmetrical. That's why Iyy equal to again pi t r cube. Now j equal to summations of the Ixx plus Iyy. That's why pi t r cube plus pi t r cube, j equal to, you will get. Now by putting this is in the first equations, so this becomes t divided by 2 pi t into r cube multi equal to tau divided by r's. So by using this formula, because allowable tau is the allowable shear stress, t is the torque acting, and r is the radius of the shaft, and this r, and that's why you can calculate. So what is the size of the welds required? So problems are easy. Only what is to be use these basic relations. Otherwise, if you remember this formula, you can directly calculate the value of the shear stress. Value of the size of the weld. Note down problems. A circular shaft50 mm in diameter it is welded to the support by means of circumferential fillet weld and shown in figure. It is subjected to torsional moment of
2500 newton meter determine the size of the weld. If the permissible shear stress in the weld is 140 newton per mm squares. So this is simple problems by using it is subjected to torsional moments. This is newton meters by using solution torque equations T divided by J equal to tau divided by R. Now this tau T equal to 2500 multiplied by, because this is meter, that's why this is 1000 and this is 2 pi into T R cube, J equal to, and tau equal to, this is given 140 and this is R. Now this R and 1 will get cancelled. So what is remaining? Now T equal to, and this is 2500 multiplied by 1000 divided by 2 into pi divided by, now this is R squares, means R equal to, welded to the by means of circumference of filament as shown in figure, it is subjected. So we request shaft, this is 50 mm and R equal to 25 squares. That's why, correct? No, this is 140 is remaining. Multiplied by 1000 divided by 2 divided by pi divided by 25 square divided by 140. This is equal to, T equal to 4.54 mm and H equal to, this is size of the weld, divided by, this is 6.43. directly, purposefully I am writing, this is the required, determine the size of the weld. This is size of the weld. This is your expected answer. Another one simple problems. Related with these articles, I will take, and after that we can close this chapters is the welded joints. Note down, this D equal to is given, D equal to 120 mm. For this process, note down, a circular rod of, a circular rod of 120 mm diameter is welded to a place, and this is the place which is to be welded to a plate. This is not place, to a plate, by means of, this is given, by means of 10 mm fillet. Now this is given directly. Means this is h mm. H equal to 10 mm. Determine the maximum twisting moment. Maximum twisting moment which can be applied, which can be applied to the rod if the permissible shear stress is shear stress is 80 newton per mm squares. This is given. So what is to be calculate? Maximum twisting moments. Means twisting moment is nothing but the toe that is to be calculated. And yes, by means of the 10 fillet ms, means h is given. Solution. Fillet weld size 10 mm, that is equal to leg h. Is h equal to 10 mm, t equal to, that's why 10 means this is 7.07 mm, t equal to. And now by using formula t divided by j equal to toe divided by ass. Now this t, this is to be calculated. J equal to, we know formula, 2 pi into t into r cube equal to tau equal to at, and this is r. That's why 2 pi t into r squares equal to at, because this r and one r will get cancelled, and t equal to, this is twisting moment, equal to 80 into 2 into pi into t equal to 7.07 mm multiplied by r squares. R equal to 120 divided by 2 square, right? And this is, you will get in terms of newton mm. This is your expected answer. (60)² × (7.07) × (pi) × (2) × (80). Now this is, means the strain, the how much is the torque acting, that is equal to 12.793 × 10⁶. This much is the torque that you can apply. So I think these problems are sufficient. Now I explain our all types of the welded joints, and I solve maximum problems, means varieties of the problems related with the welded joints. So that's why I declare here this completing of the welded joints. So in the next class, we'll see riveted joints. If the, according to the syllabus, is the riveted joints, that I will take in the next class. Thank you.